everybody, it's Tallboy here, and the Maytag has been temporarily set aside. Not because there's anything wrong with it, but because something is taking its place. We have a new member of the family here in the Tallboy household. We have the Maytag, as you know, and the Speed Queen, but a recent new addition is this. This is a Sears Kenmore. From 1968. This was recently found on Craigslist. Let me show you the model numbers right in here. What I found doing a little research online with Kenmore appliances is prior to 1974, when you look at the model number, the first two digits after the decimal point, so it's the 110 decimal point, and then the 68 indicates the model year of the model, and then the 14700 is the actual model. After, like, 1974 on, it was the first number and the third number was the model year. But so this is a 68 model year machine. The person I bought it from was the second owner of it, and he told me that the person who bought it in 67, which either could potentially be a misremembering of when he bought it, or it could be that maybe it was made in late 67 as a 68 model, and maybe he did buy it in 67. But let's take a look at it up close. This is a Whirlpool belt drive washer, so it's the Sears Kenmore self-cleaning filter washer. This is what you call one of the alphabet washers, as all the cycles are programmed in as an alphabet. This is just a sticker. It's no buttons or anything there. And then what you do is when you set the dial for the different cycles, you set it to the letter for the cycle you want. So if you're looking to wash cotton, linens, whites, you set it to A, which A is right there. And each cycle does different things, all right? It also, I'll get to that in a minute. There's a water level selector, which is a full range selector. You can set it, you know, anywhere you want in the range to adjust your water level. And then it has what it's called a cold water option, which gives you a cold wash, which would also in turn give you a cold rinse, or just a cold rinse. As you can see, the temperatures for the different cycles, there's no switch for like hot wash, warm wash, cold wash. That's all set by which cycle you select when you set it. On the inside of the lid, it gives the list of what all the different cycles are, and you know the what the wash temperature is, what the agitation speed is, how much the wash time is for that particular cycle, what the rinse temperature is, what the spin speed is, and how long the spin lasts. So say if we're doing cottons and linens, would be A. So that would be a hot water wash with normal agitation, with a 14-minute wash cycle, with a warm rinse, normal spin speed for 6 minutes for the final spin. And it's different for each different cycle, so eventually we'll get through all the cycles and we'll try them all out here. Let's take a look down inside. It's got a liquid bleach dispenser. And down in here it has a, as if we can maybe zoom in, maybe we can see what it says it's a super roto swirl agitator, which is supposed to be one of the better agitators up until they developed the dual action agitator. And it's all nice white porcelain inside. So I bought this, like I said, the other day on Craigslist. I had to drive about an hour from here to go pick it up. And I've run a couple loads with it. I set it up here, got it balanced, and or not balanced, but leveled. So it's level front to back and side to side, or really close. I couldn't get it exactly right because the feet don't want to adjust. They're kind of stuck. But I got it, you know, as level as I can. It's only off by like maybe half a bubble or something, so it's not too bad. And the other thing I had to do was I had to buy a new drain hose for it, so I installed a new drain hose. And other than that, I've done a couple test runs on it, and the only issue that it had was the belt would squeal when it would go into spin. And so I took a look at the belt, and I didn't see any like dry rot cracks or anything like that, and it looks like it was just, it's probably the original belt. And so I took some, I think I got it right over here, little Crestone belt dressing, and I sprayed the belt with that to make it a little more tacky, and that seems to have cured the problem with the squealing belt. So I think the belt is fine. I did do some research online. I was looking to try to find the part number for the replacement belt for this machine, and I'll go to the, like, you know, appliance parts websites, you know, various ones online, and enter the model number, and it shows me all kinds of parts that are available for this machine, some that aren't even available anymore, but the one part it won't show me is the belt. So I don't know what the belt is, or if all these washers took the same belt, you know, from the beginning of time up until they discontinued them. I'm going to have to do some more research, maybe on automatic washer or some other website like that, to try to figure out what the deal is with it. And so the only other thing I will say is that the guy told me when he bought it that it was a fairly quiet running machine, and I'm assuming he's right. The issue that I have is it's sitting up on a raised wood platform, which is hollow underneath, so that acts basically like a big reverberation chamber for the sound of the motor running and stuff, which makes it actually sound a lot louder than I think it is if it was just sitting on the concrete floor. But since my floor is not level, and this platform is, that's what we have to go with. All right, so I've got a small load of colors that I'm going to run. And once I get that set up, I'll be back. Okay, so I'm going to be using some Persil laundry detergent, which I'll put in here. And then we've got a bunch of clothes to go in. And we're just going to run this, actually, let me zoom back over here on the, if I can get the camera to move here a little bit, we'll look at the cycle to see what I'm going to do. See if I can zoom in a little here. All right, so I'm going to run this as a B cycle, which is cottons, linens, and coloreds. All right, so is B. This is a different than a modern washer. This is a push to start, pull to stop timer. So you got to pull it out, and then, oops, gonna spin it around and set it on B. And without showing you the lid again right off, oops, I think I went past it. Let me get back on here. There. B is a warm wash, normal agitation. Wash time is 10 minutes, and it has a warm rinse and a normal spin speed for 6 minutes. And so, one other thing I
will point out to you, let me point this back down at the washer here and zoom back out again. If you notice, if I can get this turned around, there's no catch anywhere around or hole or lever or anything for a lid switch on here. I don't know if there's a lid switch somehow built into the hinge on this, but it operates, it does everything with the lid open, although it says right at the bottom of the all the instructions on the lid, it says important basket will not spin when lid is raised, but it does. So it either has a lid switch that's somehow built into the hinge that has failed and it's been hot wired, or it failed in the closed position, or it just doesn't have one at all. I don't know when a lid switch became a safety feature that washers had to have, but I'm assuming that at some point they decided that they had to have them. So I didn't have to do any hot wiring of the lid switch or sticking a pencil in a hole to make it run. It'll just run on its own. All right, so let me just tip back up here just a little bit and we'll see us start the washer. This knob on the top too is also all metal. It's not plastic. And I think all these knobs are metal. So it's this machine actually weighs a lot more than the Maytag does. It's a heavy son of a gun. All right, so here we're gonna go. We're gonna start here. Little bit of the story behind this washer, for what I was told by the owner. He bought it from a gentleman who had been an appliance repairman for many years. He said that gentleman bought it brand new. He was up in the Albany, New York area, and when he went and bought this washer from him, I think he was selling him a refrigerator that he had. He had a like 1930s vintage refrigerator that he was selling. And he sold it to this gentleman and then bought the washer. I think that's the story. But this guy, since he was a repairman, kind of collected interesting machines over the years. So even though he bought this machine new, it didn't see an awful lot of use from the original owner, who owned it from, he said 1967, so I'll go with his word, from 67 up until, I think he said 2004 is when the gentleman I bought it from bought it. And he used it very little during that time because he actually had a garage, and all along one wall was like one set after another of different vintage washers and dryers and stuff. And so he kind of spread the use around on his different machines, I'm assuming. The guy I bought it from basically used it as a daily driver from 2004 up until just this year. But he is a single person, or basically for the most part living, you know, alone by himself. So it wasn't seeing a huge use like if it was a whole family. But the reason that he sold it was one of those boy meets girl and falls in love and gets married, and then the girl finds out that the boy has a whole bunch of vintage appliances, and she's like, ew, vintage appliances are icky, I want new ones. And also the girl was not from New England originally, and so she wanted to move back to the Midwest where she was from. And I believe she's already moved back, and he's getting ready to move back. And so instead of moving this machine, off we go. Instead of moving this machine, he decided to sell it. And I told him that I'm basically going to buy it and make it a YouTube star. So, sorry, my voice is getting a little crappy here. So, enjoy the show. Thank you. I did rinse out my cup for the detergent. This is the high water level setting. I didn't mention what I had the water level set at, but it's set all the way up on high. Notice with this machine, as you can see, is it has really aggressive turnover. Very impressed with it. It's like, I think sometimes it's better than my Maytag. There we have it. The first maiden wash for YouTube on the 1968 Sears Kenmore model 110.68 14700. 1968 model Whirlpool made Kenmore washer. Stay tuned, we'll have more videos soon going through all the different cycles. Thanks a lot. Take care now. Bye.